Hey everybody, Longtongue's back, and I'm gonna play a video game. Y'all like video games, I like video games too. Don't worry about the menu freaking out, that's just it being whatever, I keep wanting to tell myself to play Zoom and Zoop, but let's just give this a little look. Let's give some stuff a look. You might play, Side Pike? That's on this. Let's try Flicky. I mean, it's also a game that no one's heard of. I wanted to play Zoom and Zoop because alliteration. And because... also because they're all so weird games no one's heard of. I like playing weird games that no one's heard of. Because, like, not a lot of people will talk about them. So, here's Flicky. Here's a cute-ass little bird boy. So it's like a little hotel place you're in. Look at all the pretty colors. Everything's green. I don't know who the interior decorator was, but they decided that this place was gonna be green, and that there's a train on the top level, and an elephant on the second highest level, and they said to themselves, "That's what I want to do." Little did they know that interior decorator was probably blind, but that's okay. We like it for how it is. It's unique. So he plays this little bird. His name is Flicky. And, he's picking up his little baby chicks and take him to the elevator or whatever. I want to say it's an elevator because you hear little elevator music and stuff. Well, the elevator dings, not really elevator music, but you know what I mean. It kind of has that vibe, in my opinion. Oh no! I missed that final jump. Bonus rounds are a little tricky, but if you get the bonus rounds down like perfect, you feel really cool. The controls are really tight. Well, there's a little bit of slip and slide, but it's just kind of the uniqueness to the controls. It wants you to adapt to it. I've messed up on level 4. Fine, that's okay. I'll make up for it. I'm actually pretty good at this game. But yeah! The levels of this game get actually pretty weird. They, like, go from, like, this cute little hotel-looking place, house place, to, like, a space station. It's, like, really weird, but, like, as you get farther in the game, like, pieces of the wall start falling off. It's, like, weird. I don't know if this is supposed to be, like, I don't know what the hell the world is about in this game. So, right, what I'm doing right now is I'm actually collecting all of them so I can chain a combo. And then, like, if you do it fast, you get a time bonus. It's really cool. I'm just gonna hide under here for a second. There we go. People say, how the hell are you playing this on a phone? Are you ridiculous? That's just eewee. And it's like, that's why I'm playing simple arcade games for now, is because playing any other kind of game on a phone, on an emulator, is weird in general. Even if you have a Bluetooth controller, that just feels so whack. Good jump! That was scary. I'm just gonna wait for a second. He's right there. There you go. He's right over there. Got him. Okay, we got it. Lead the winner. Yeah, you get a really high time bonus if you get it done really early. I think everything's working pretty good. Yeah, so this game is, like, really cute as frick, and one of the main character is actually is kind of like a side character in a Sonic game. Like, if you ever played Sonic 3D Blast, which is, like, the earliest 3D-ish Sonic game, it's not even that. It has 3D elements, but it isn't, like, a full-on 3D thing. You're still, I mean, kind of, I would say it's a full-on 3D thing. It's been forever since I played it, so I had to defog my brainium. My brainium and my cranium. Yeah. There we go. We're gonna do a couple playthroughs of this. We're gonna try this a couple times. Heck, I might even beat my record on accident. Well, my last Let's Play record. My last data got corrupted. I had no idea how I did that, but I did it. Yeah, the items ricochet, which really help. You would think you'd have to aim yourself directly at them, but you really don't. You just kind of have to have it in close proximity. Yeah! There we go. Okay, they went the other way. I can usually get to, like, level 20 in this. But I'm so nervous. I've been so nervous this time around, because I actually have people who are actually going to watch my video for once. So it's like, oh, I gotta be funny. I did it. Level 10. Level 24, I think, is my record, and that's usually when you're in space and shit. I don't know how many levels there are until the reset. But there's alcohol. Everybody likes alcoholic beverages. Beverage. That's why it has the word rage in it, because it's all the rage. Yeah. Oh, that frog is gonna get me. Oh god, this level is intense. Got it. I just gotta get to the— oh my god, no, just let me jump over the tiny gap. If it let you do that, it would've been, like, really cool. Oh, there's the last one. Just— oh my god, frick. I don't know how I ever got past that level long ago. Let's try one more time, frick. I'm gonna check— actually, I won't check anything. It's still going. We'll try one more time. I'm recording in a different place too. Usually I record in my bedroom where it's all comfy. But I'm kind of recording in a weird place. And it's also a different time of day than when I usually record. Usually I'm a pretty loose guy at night, but I'm actually recording this a little bit after lunchtime. So it's kind of like a weird time. Beep. Dang, I really do hope people watch this. Usually I never care about people watching it, because it's like, I'm gonna show this to a friend or two. Ha, laugh at my awful video quality. Because for the longest time, I was just like, either setting my phone down in front of a television screen, like a dingus, or, using really low quality video quality, because I didn't have enough space on my phone. I would need, like, a legit full gigabyte just to get— ugh. It's that first one, and also talking while playing. I'm very new to this still. At least my commentary has gotten much better in the year, over the years. La la la. Lee-lee-lee-la. There's so many windows. There's a lot of windows. No. Oh yeah, that's another part of the mechanic. I thought I was still dead. Got it. I win. I need it. Is that if you you collect your chain, you get your of chicks. But if a cat gets in the middle of the line, they all fall off. So then you're like, oh god. So you gotta recollect them, and then they're all lost, and they look silly because half of them are wearing sunglasses for some reason. Poopy. That's okay. I think I got it. I didn't get it. I didn't get it. I used to be so good that I would, like, skip platforms. Like, I could jump over, like, multiple platforms to get to a place, and it would, like, really shave time. Like, there's some really cool, like, speed tricks to this game, and I bet a speedrun for this game would be really cool to watch, actually. Because it's a lot of, like, very specific movements and stuff to get better times. Because once you bump off a thing, it kind of messes up your time a little bit. I got it. Well, I collected one back up. One thing I really like to get better at in this game is when I dodge, like, the close distance dodging of the cats, because, like, that can really help a lot. Also, hitting them when they're both together feels amazing. I think more cats get added in as the game goes on. The girl sees, sir. There we go. Actually, to be honest, the bonus levels are actually really tricky. Just because of how weird inside you are and how specific you really have to be. I wonder if... I kind of wish this building existed in real life. It would be really weird. It feels like a preschool. But at least the windows make a little more sense. I kind of, like, the more I've played this game, the more I've realized that maybe this is, like, some weird-ass Salvador Dali-ish land or some shit. Because, like I said, the walls fall apart, and then become, like, more in space. And if you looked out the windows in certain levels, it's, like, you see, like, little pyramids and shit. But then the inside, it doesn't really fit with that kind of deserty landscape. I'm dead. It's like, I'm not... It's like, when in the world would this be in a desert? What kind of world am I in? It's just not a lot of world building in Flicky. Just because of how it's built. You just get little tiny snippets and hints, and you're like trying to build it together in your brain. But you're like, what the fuck is happening? Where am I? Why am I? What? It reminds me a lot of Flicky. I think I barely won that. I don't know why I even dared that. I didn't even know how many chicks I had left. It's a good place to stay for a little bit. Oh, yo! Don't hate me. Good. I'm probably not gonna get the time bonus now, but that's okay. I think I can win. I think I got it. Oh no, there's one left! Are you fucking serious right now? I'm usually so much better. Like, see, there's the weird pyramid shit. Look how spooky that is. Oh. Okay. Wow. Wow. Just nervous. God. It's so icky. I'm so scared. Here's the bonus round. I'm actually pretty close to last night's record. I tried recording this last night, and the footage got corrupted. And it's there we go. I only missed one that time. Go away. There we go. Yep, here's a spooky land. Yeah, I don't even get the sunglass thing either. Like, it's supposed to be like a personalization of the characters or whatever, but like a cool kid or something, but like it's like on half of them, but then the other half don't. And that freaking frog, man, I don't even know what, or lizard thing, I don't even know what to say about that thing. It's just so random, it feels like. Oh, he came at me in the air. I was pretty close. Well, we're probably gonna try to play this again sometime, and we're gonna probably try to play some other games. Flicky's fun. Flicky's great. Look at the funnies. Look at the funny character. Look at him dance. I don't know. Alright, I'm gonna go. See you later.